In Washington today, a group of Holocaust survivors returned to the Capitol for a day of remembrance, reminding younger generations of past horrors and of future challenges. Ray Suarez reports.
Under a steady rain, thousands came to mark the 20th anniversary of the dedication of a museum built as a constant reminder of one of history's greatest crimes, Nazi Germany's murder of 6 million Jews.
Time is an all-important factor in the thinking and planning of mankind.
Between 1933 and 1945, Adolf Hitler led Germany and its collaborators first to systematically persecute, then attempt to eliminate European Jewry. Today's ceremony brought together more than 800 Holocaust survivors and more than 100 military veterans who took part in liberating Europe and the death camps. But there probably won't be too many more gatherings like this one. It's almost 70 years since VE Day. Even those who were liberated as children are in their 80s and 90s. Natalie Gonen-Rendler is one of those child survivors from Poland. She recounted what she remembers seeing when she was just 3 years old.
A little baby was crying, and the German yelled in German, "Stop the baby from crying. Mach still." That's what he yelled, you know? How do you make a baby stop crying? She couldn't stop the baby crying. He grabbed the baby, set the little baby down. There was a fence around the tree, a spiky fence. The blood was gushing all over. That's what I saw at 3 years old.
It was on another rainy, windy day in 1993 that President Bill Clinton and Nobel laureate and Holocaust survivor Elie Wiesel dedicated the nation's Holocaust Memorial Museum.
For the dead and the living, we must bear witness.
This museum is not for the dead alone, nor even for the survivors who have been so beautifully represented. It is perhaps most of all for those of us who were not there at all, to learn the lessons, to deepen our memories and our humanity, and to transmit these lessons from generation to generation.
Now, 20 years later, under a massive tent, the same two men called on the world to prevent future genocides from happening.
You are now the flag bearers. It is your memory that inherits ours. Our memory will live in yours. Remember that, young people, that now you have an ideal, not only an idea, but ideal. The ideal of saving whatever the past has to offer for the future and its heroes and also its victims.
Make sure that as direct memories fade away, that the records, the pictures, and the stories never die. To make sure that we will always be able to come here to remind us that no matter how smart a people are, if you have a head without a heart, you are not human.
The museum has seen more than 35 million people pass through its doors since it opened just off the National Mall. It's full of audio and video testimonials from survivors, a model of the gas chamber at Auschwitz, artifacts from victims' lives, like the stack of shoes they took off before being put to death in the gas chambers, and the faces of those who were killed in Hitler's genocide. The museum's director, Sarah Bloomfield, said the core mission of the museum is to educate, but it's also about helping prevent future genocides.
Evil is not an ineradicable disease. It will be here forever. Human beings will face future genocides. And our responsibility is to do for future victims of genocide what the world failed to do for the Jews of Europe in the 1930s and 40s.
92-year-old Henry Hirschman is both a survivor and a veteran. He fled to America from Germany as a teenager and ended up going back as a young GI, where he walked through the barracks at Dachau. Now he tells his story to school children.
We're talking about history, and I constantly hope, and something that I told my two children as they were growing up, I said, can't you love one another? It's a lot easier than hate. And if that transformed itself to the people in this world to love one another, I think it would become a better world.
There are other Holocaust memorials and museums around the world, like Israel's Yad Vashem and Berlin's memorial built in 2004. And just last week, Canada announced plans to build a memorial in Ottawa, the only former Allied nation without one.
You can watch videos from today's ceremony online, including speeches from President Clinton and Elie Wiesel. Find those on our YouTube page.